When it comes to our blood pressure, anything over 140 on that upper number is high. As Barb Smith, though, is here to explain, that benchmark could change because of a $100 million study with local participants.
That's right, Robert. The study is funded by the National Institutes of Health. The University of Utah and Intermountain Medical Center will be participating along with others nationwide. The goal is to see if treating people with medicine in that mid-range between 120 and 140 will save lives for your family.
This better be good.
David Hildebrand is having a blood pressure check. He's working out at Intermountain Medical Center.
I didn't monitor my blood pressure, my triglycerides, my cholesterol.
And it resulted in bypass surgery. His doctor says he needs to bring his blood pressure down to 120 over 80.
It's something to take care of and look at. Otherwise, you wind up with a scar from here to here, five bypasses and all of the ill effects of surgery.
But there is still some uncertainty about when to treat high blood pressure.
The old guidelines recommended that our blood pressure, the top number, should be at least lower than 140. And if you have diabetes, it should be lower than 130.
But if normal is 120, and there's a reduction of risk for every point lower than 140, what about the people in between?
The question comes, well, would it be useful to actually treat to the normal level? And it would require more medicine, and there's more side effects that might happen, and so it hasn't actually been proposed before.
But he says there is mounting evidence it might be worth it, which is why it is now being studied in 7,500 patients.
They're going to follow them for at least 5 years and see how many heart attacks are stopped and how many deaths are stopped and how many strokes are stopped.
And they are also studying the impact of lower blood pressure on dementia and Alzheimer's. And the end result could be that 120 becomes the guideline for everybody.
If you don't want to die, have a stroke, have a heart attack, go into kidney failure and need to go on dialysis, or become demented, then this study is important for you.
And Intermountain will begin recruiting people with high blood pressure for this study in about 2 months. The result will be available in about 7 years.
Now, I've always been told if I eat right, you know, I stay in shape, I can keep my blood pressure down. That case?
Sadly, no. And I thought it was too, which is why I asked today. But Dr. Muhlstein says while it certainly will help keep your blood pressure in check, as we get older, it's a natural part of our aging process for that blood pressure to creep up. And he said it's really difficult as we get older to bring it down without medication.
All right, good information. Thank you, Barb.
You bet.